A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 21st March, on the front page you have Nirav Modi's free run ends, held without bail in London. So we had seen that Nirav Modi, who is wanted in the 13,000 crore Punjab National Bank fraud case, has now been arrested in London. He had fled to UK and now he has been denied bail and arrested. So he had offered court an assurance including 5 lakh pounds as security, but he was arrested without bail. And this is Asim Anand, 3 others acquitted in Samjhota case. So this is the Samjhota Express, the India-Pakistan train in which the blast took place in 2007. We had seen the case being heard by an NIA court, National Investigation Agency court, and now the court has acquitted, means set free 4 people including main accused Swami Asim Anand. So these are right-wing members who were accused in the Samjhota Express train blast in which many Pakistanis died. So it was India-Pakistan train coming to India from Pakistan and the blast took place. Then on page 5 you have put off loan waiver payment till poll ends, Election Commission tells Karnataka. So the election panel has decided, decision is based on logic that the scheme entails cash transfer, because the farm loan waiver which is provided is, it should not be implemented while the poll is going on, is what the election commission has told the Karnataka government, which had announced this loan waiver. Then on page 7 you have, will study order on Asim Anand, NIA, National Investigation Agency. So it said that it will seek legal advice on challenging the acquittal too. So this is a continuation of the front page news, the Samjhota Express blast case in which the NIA court has acquitted the accused. Asim Anand is a former RSS member. He and 5 others have been acquitted. Then this is Godhra case, accused sentenced to life. So accused was on the run for 16 years and now he has been arrested and sentenced to life. Regarding the 2002 Godhra train carnage in which car sevaks were killed. So there were 59 people who were charged to death in this case, Godhra case in Gujarat, post which we saw the Gujarat riots as a retaliation to this train carnage. So Yakub was one of the most wanted accused in this case. He was on the run for 16 years and now he has been arrested in Jan 2018 and now sentenced to life by a special investigation team court. Then below you have about 44% of PM Kisan beneficiaries await payment from center. So with just 10 days to go for the first payout deadline under PM Kisan, only 2.74 crore farm families, or about 56% of the total list of 4.92 crore names submitted by the states, have been paid so far. The remaining 2.18 crore farm families are still waiting processing or are caught somewhere between the 4-stage validation process set up to weed out fakes. So it was set up late, the validation process to weed out fakes. So it has delayed the payments to these families. Only 44% beneficiaries have been made the payment. So this is regarding the PM Kisan scheme, which was announced in the budget and was set to be implemented even before the period of the budget. So the first installment of 2000 rupees was to be paid by 31st March. So that has not been paid to all farmers. Only 44% got. On the editorial page, the first editorial is a lot to lose. So this is regarding Tamil Nadu's regional political parties. So it is said they are logged in a national battle. This is basically regarding AIADMK and DMK. So generally AIADMK has always formed an alliance with BJP and DMK with Congress. Then below you have useful tool. So this is regarding the dollar rupee swap which was used by RBI to manage liquidity. So this is said to be a useful tool in this editorial. Then the lead article here is a short history of data. So this is regarding the recent undermining of credibility of India's statistical output. So it says this why it is regrettable. Data is undermined. So we have seen this in news statisticians have been facing, you know, there have been two groups, one opposing the suppressing of data by the government and another one which is upholding and saying that the data by the government is credible and has to be accepted on face value. Then this is reality of impunity, rhetoric of human rights. So this is regarding isolated innovations are not enough to stop cases of custodial torture. So this is speaking about how custodial torture cases have to be stopped and steps are being taken, but isolated steps, isolated innovations are not enough. And it talks about even UN conventions on the matter, etc. There's UN Convention Against Torture of 1997. But then action taken is not sufficient. Then on the op-ed page you have the case of the missing election in Jammu and Kashmir. So it says the failure to hold assembly polls shows up problems in the working of the election commission. So why elections were not announced for Jammu and Kashmir is a question raised here. Then this is hold them responsible. So this says the fight against terrorism can never succeed without holding people to account for costly lapses. So we have to fight terrorism. The counter-terrorism efforts or the counter-terrorism measures should be very strong. So people have to be held accountable for lapses. That's what the argument is put forth in this article. On international page, you have short Brexit delay possible only if UK Parliament backs deal. So this is what European Union has said, that extension beyond May 23. Will pose institutional difficulties and legal uncertainty. So there will be only a short Brexit delay is what EU has accepted. So if in that time frame, UK is coming up with a deal. Then below you have Kazakhstan renames capital as new president takes office. So Kazakhstan's capital was named Astana. Now it will be called Nur Sultan after former president. Then besides this, you have this image of Mozambique floods, which is discussed in news yesterday too. It was there on front page, and India has also offered help here in the Mozambique flood crisis. Below you have 40 animals to be rescued from Gaza zoo. So this is regarding Gaza strip of Palestinian territory. So here animal rescue NGO says that far too long they have had to live under dreadful conditions, so now they have been rescued. Then this is Pakistan to sell unused government property to pay off debt. So cash-strapped Pakistan government has now decided to sell unused properties owned by federal ministries to pay off the country's mounting debts. So there's a huge debt on the government, you can see. So there's a debt of over 27 trillion Pakistani rupees which it has to repay. Then on business page you have Angel Techs. CBDT, DPIIT trade blames for delay in resolving issues. So Angel Tax issue has to be resolved. The DPIIT, that is Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. So this is a body department under the Ministry of Finance. So this and the Central Board of Direct Taxes. So they both have to work together. The DPIIT was set to issue notification stating that the registered startups would be exempted from the angel tax. So the names would be forwarded from DPIIT, so Central Board of Direct Taxes, and they should be exempted. So angel tax exemptions have been announced because it is taking a toll on the startups. So that is why this announcement has been made, but still in implementation it has not come into effect. So that's the problems which are being faced. It is said earlier, we had seen in news how it was stated that the back-end infrastructure which is required, you know, the online infrastructure required, you know, by CPDT has not been set up. So you can see this is regarding this delay being discussed here. Then on the last page you have integrate TB services with primary health system. So this is Lancet saying so. So there are 8 million lives which could be saved with subsidized tests, support, etc. So this is regarding tuberculosis. Diagnosis and treatment need improvement is what the Lancet report says. And below you have Finland is the happiest nation. India slips 7 spots, ranks 140th. So this is regarding World Happiness Report, the World Happiness Index, in which Finland is number one. India is at 140th rank. South Sudan is the unhappiest country as such. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com. Thank you.